Thanks for purchasing my premium gig. I will show you how to use this template. So, to use this template, you required to activate the developer mode. So, here you will see there is no developer option in menu section. So, I have to activate the developer option first. For this, go to File, Option, Customize Ribbon and Developer. Check it. OK. Now you will see the developer menu is activated. The second thing required is put your all data in Excel file in corresponding column. I will provide you a Excel template where you put all your data in corresponding column. So it is the template, Excel template. This is a sample and this is your blank one. This is for you to put your all data in this place. Serial number 1, 1 means first block. So all the first block data comes here, 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 here. Second block data goes here, 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 here in this place. Third block data goes here. As you see, this is the first block. This is the first block data. All data from the first block. This is the second block data. This is the third block data. I will show you. Yes, this is the first block data. 1 in 100 probability cow and this picture all comes from this template. All comes from this template. And here I am using online image URL, HTTPS. If you are using Office 2019, then you can use online URL. And if you are using Office 2016, then you cannot use this URL. Use then local URL. So first all the image you have to store in a desktop or any location, and from there you have to give the path from here, C user and the location actually. So if all your data is ready, then we go to the next step. Okay, next step is open PowerPoint template file. This is the file and it's a 100 card block template, and I embedded 3 VBA code or macros in this file. So go to developer mode and here this is the macros. If I click this here, this is the 3 macros: add data to block step 2, likhawa, create block card step 1, and save to full HD step 3. Now I will show you how to generate any number of blocks or cards presentation. Now I will show you. So this is the 100 card template and I want to generate 11 card template. So how can I do? So first go to macros. And here step 1, this is create blocks and cards, select it and run, and it will asking for please enter how many blocks or cards you want to create. I want to create 11 cards. 11, hit OK. Now macro is running. Okay, so when I click, wait for some time, but it's 11 is a small number, so it's generate too early. But if you put 50 or 60, then it will take a 30 second or 20 seconds. So it's completed. The message shows it's completed. Okay, now how can I how can I trust? So go to arrange and selection pane. So here you see, yes, graphic 11. So 11 card already generated. Graphic means this. This is graphic 11 and group 11. So 11 card already generated. Next thing is, so I already completed 11 block. Now I have to insert my custom data to this 11 block. So my data is here in this Excel file, in this Excel file, sample file, and keep in a desktop delivery folder. Okay, so now go to here, developer, macros, step 2, add data to block, add data to block, select it, run it. Please enter the number of blocks where you want to insert data. 11 block, 11. Hit OK. Confirm you want to insert. OK. Please select or browse data Excel file from your computer. So where I can store my customized data? It's my desktop. It's my desktop delivery folder. And this is the sample. This is the sample. Yes, it. This is the file. And this is for your data. Blank file now. Okay. Select. So all the data imported from that Excel file to its presentation file, PowerPoint presentation file. Wait for some time to complete. It's completed already. Updated successfully. Okay. So till now I generated 11 block, then I inserted data in this 11 block. Now so please checking that the 11 block is created. Okay. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Fantastic. 11. So 11 is lost. Beautiful. Great. Okay. Thanks for watching. So now it's created. Now I want to add the sound file, audio file. So for this, I require an audio file and I keep it in desktop, and you will be provide a formula. You will provide a formula, minimum length of the audio file. So I here I am generated 11 files, 11 blocks. So 11 for 11 blocks, we need a minimum 32 seconds, minimum 32 seconds audio file. Now I add the audio file, insert. Okay. Now insert audio on my PC. Where is my audio? In my desktop. This is the insert. Okay. Now drag it to left side here. Okay. Now there is some settings in audio file. So first stream the audio, and audio file must be in the second slide, not in a first slide, only second slide. Remember it, only second slide. Now it's 3 minutes 37 seconds. I need a 32 second. So trim it to 32 seconds. 36, 31, 33, 32. Okay, 32 seconds. Fade in, fade out. You can give a 7, 7. It's general 7 and 7. Now go to volume, select medium, sequence automatically, play across slide, hide during show, and then play in background. When you press the play in background, then here loop until stop is all checked. Unchecked it. Okay, now you run the presentation. Good. Now everything is fine, and now you make a presentation, complete presentation, what you want with audio file. The next part is how to save this presentation. You have two options to save this presentation into MP4 or Windows Media File WMV. I recommended always save in WMV file, not MP4. So for this, you can run these presentations and use any screen recorder to record these presentations. You can use OBS Studio. It's good. And the second option is, if you use screen recorder, it's required less time. 2 minutes, 3 minutes, as long as your presentation time. But if you want to save it a full HD, then I strongly recommend use a micro I already provide. So go to developer, and this is a micro, save to full HD step 3, click it and run. Please enter your title name, written custom, CUSTOM.